Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again on the video lecture series on the subject steam nozzle. This is problem number 6. Actually, earlier we discussed the theory on the steam nozzle and discussed 5 sets of problems from various university question papers. Now, presently, this is the 6th set of problems from Anna University question paper. And these are all the books I published, written and published earlier. So, the design of turbo machine, design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I publish, upload the video lectures on the subject mentioned here, and the video lectures on GATE question paper, the solution of the GATE question paper is also uploaded. So use the YouTube channel, subscribe the YouTube channel, and for your better learning. And before we take the problem to solve, now we review the equations required to solve the problem. First, the specific volume of the steam. So, for wet steam, we have 1 minus x into Vf plus x into Vg. Normally, Vf value is very, very small. So, we ignore Vf value. So, V wet equal to x into Vg. We take x into Vg. Specific volume of dry steam, V dry equal to Vg. Vg is directly available in the steam table. Superheated steam, V super equal to Vg into T by Ts, and the specific volume of the superheated steam is also available in the table number 4 of steam table. Then specific enthalpy of the steam. So for wet steam, H wet equal to Hf plus X into Hfg. Hf and Hfg value from the steam table for the given pressure. Dry steam, H dry equal to Hg. Hg is directly available in the steam table. For superheated steam, H super equal to Hg plus Cp into T minus Ts, where Hg is the enthalpy of dry saturated steam, Cp is the specific heat of the steam. Normally, you take the value 2.2. If the value is not given, you take 2.2, and Ts is the saturation temperature. And the superheated steam, enthalpy of the superheated steam is also directly available in table number 5. Specific entropy of the steam. For wet steam, S wet equal to Sf plus X into Sfg. Dry steam, S dry equal to Sg. Sg is directly available in the steam table for a given pressure and temperature. For superheated steam, S super equal to Sg plus Cp into logarithmic of T by Ts. And specific entropy of the superheated steam is also directly available in the steam table. Now, we take the example number 5 from November 2019 question paper. A steam nozzle is supplied with steam at a 15 bar, 350 degrees Celsius and discharges steam at 1 bar. If the divergent portion of the nozzle is 80 mm long and the throat diameter is 6 mm, determine the cone angle of the divergent portion. Assume 12% of total available enthalpy drop is lost in friction in the divergent portion. Also determine the velocity and temperature of the steam at the throat. So this is the convergent divergent nozzle. So the section 1 is taken as, section 1 is the inlet, 2 is the throat section and 3 is the exit section. The pressure P1 at the entry 15 bar, the temperature is 350 degrees Celsius. P3 pressure at the exit section is 1 bar. Length of the divergent portion from 2 to 3, the horizontal length is 80 mm and the diameter D2 equal to 6 mm. And from the steam table, we have to take the property. So at the inlet 15 bar 350 degrees Celsius, it is superheated steam. So, the enthalpy H1, 15 bar, 350 degrees Celsius, 3148.7 kilojoules per kilogram, and the entropy entropy 15 bar 350 degrees Celsius 7.104. So 7.104 is the entropy, and specific enthalpy is 3148.7 kilojoules per kilogram. Now for the throat section, we have to calculate the pressure. So we use the critical pressure ratio. So P2 by P1 equal to 2 by n plus 1 to the power n by n minus 1. So at the entry, it is superheated stream. So for superheated stream, the value of n equal to 1.3. So if the value is not given, you have to take 1.3. So P2 equal to 15 into 2 by 1.3 plus 1 to the power 1.3 divided by 1.3 minus 1. So you calculate, it is 8.2 bar. And 8.2 bar, the steam table, properties of the steam table, pressure table, page number 11. So 8.2 bar, we have all the values. Now you have to compare from the steam table at the throat section. P2 equal to 8.2 bar. S1, we calculated S1 earlier, 7.104, which is greater than SG2. What is SG2 for 8.2 bar? 6.65 is the SG2. So this is greater. So at the throat section, the steam is superheated. So for a superheated steam, we have to calculate the temperature of the superheated steam. So for that, you take all the properties. TS2, 171.4, you read the value 171.4, VG2 is 0.23469 meter cube per kilogram, HG 2768.4, SG 6.651 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now the steam properties at the throat section. For isentropic flow, S1 equal to S2. So S1, we know the value. Now we assume at the section 2 throat section, the steam is superheated steam. For superheated steam, the entropy is SG2 plus Cp into logarithmic of T2 by TS2. Substitute all the values, 7.104, SG2 equal to 6.651, Cp is 2.2, and logarithmic of T2 is the unknown. Temperature of the superheated steam is unknown, divided by TS2 is 444.4 Kelvin. So, we have to substitute the temperature in Kelvin. So, logarithmic of T2 by 444.4 equal to 7.104 minus 6.65 divided by 2.2 equal to 0.206. So you remove the logarithm, take e to the power exponential. So T2 by 444.4 equal to e to the power 0.206 equal to 1.23. So T2 equal to 546.6 Kelvin or 273.6 degree Celsius. Now the enthalpy of the steam at the throat section. So H2 equal to HG2 plus Cp into T2 minus TS2 equal to 2768.4 plus 2.2. Cp is 2.2. The temperature T2 equal to 273.6 minus 174.4 equal to 2993.24 kilojoules per kilogram. Then V2, specific volume at the throat section. V2 equal to VG2 for superheated steam. VG2 into T2 by TS2. So 0.23469. So T2 is 546.6 divided by TS2 equal to 444.4 equal to 0.289 meter cube per kilogram. Now the velocity of the steam at the throat section, V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2. So the friction occurs only in the divergent portion. So throat section, up to throat section, there is no friction, and the flow is isentropic. For isentropic flow, 2 into H1 minus H2. So 2 into 3148.7 minus 2993.24 into 1000. To convert kilojoules into joules, so calculating V2 equal to 557.6 meters per second. And for the exit section, P3 equal to 1 bar. So we have to take the properties. So take the steam table at 1 bar pressure. P2 equal to 1 bar. HF3 equal to 417.5 kilojoules per kilogram, HFG3 equal to 2257.9 kilojoules per kilogram, SF3 equal to 1.303 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, SFG3 equal to 6.057 and VG3 equal to 1.6938 meter cube per kilogram. Now once again, for isentropic flow, S1 equal to S3. So S1 equal to, we assume at the outlet it is wet stream. So SF3 plus X3 into SFG3. So 7.104 equal to 1.303 plus X3 into 6.057. So calculating, the drainage fraction at the outlet of the nozzle is 0.96. Now we calculate the enthalpy. So H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3. So H3 equal to 417.5 plus 0.96 into 2257.9 equal to 2585.1 kilojoules per kilogram. and the V3 specific volume V3 equal to X3 into VG3, which is 0.96 into 1.6938, which is 1.626. Now the mass flow rate of the steam. So we know the properties at the dimension at the throat section. We calculate throat area. So pi by 4 D2 square. So pi by 4 0.006 square equal to 2.826 10 power of minus 5 meter square. We calculate the mass M equal to A2 V2 by small v2. So 2.826 in 10 power minus 5 into 557.6 divided by 0.289 equal to 0.055 kilograms per second. That is the mass flow rate. Now the velocity and the area at the exit. So V3 equal to 2 into H2 minus H3 into nozzle efficiency plus V2 square. So we are calculating the enthalpy difference only in the divergent portion. So you have to consider the velocity at the throat section V2 square. So substituting 2 into 2895.56 minus 2581.5 into 1000 into 0.88 is the nozzle efficiency in the throat section. Sorry, in the divergent section. So 12% it is given in the problem, 12% energy loss. So 12% energy loss means 88% efficiency. So plus 557.6 square. So calculating the velocity at the exit is 925.9 meters per second. Now we calculate the area. So area equal to A3, area at the exit equal to M into V3, small V3 specific volume divided by capital V3 velocity equal to 0.055 into 1.626 divided by 925.9 equal to 0.966 in 10 power minus 4 meter square. That is the area at the exit. From the area, we calculate the diameter. So, diameter equal to square root of A3 into 4 by pi. So, area equal to 5 by 4 d square. So, by pi by 4 d3 square. So, d3 equal to A3 into 4 by pi. So, 0.966 in 10 power minus 4 into 4 by pi. That equal to 0.011 meter. That is 11 millimeter. So, the diameter of the exit section is 11 millimeter. Diameter of the throat section is 6 millimeter. So, from this dimensions, we are going to calculate the nozzle angle. So, we have to calculate the nozzle angle. That is the question. So, look at the diagram. Throat section diameter is 6 millimeter. Exit section diameter is 11 millimeter. Now, I have drawn the horizontal line for the D2 value. Now, the gap is the difference in the diameter. So, 2.5 millimeter at the top and 2.5 millimeter at the bottom. So, how to calculate the value? 11 minus 6, it is 5. 5 divided by 2, 2.5 millimeter. So, 2.5 millimeter here and 2.5 millimeter on the bottom. Now, the alpha is the angle here. So, this is the half of the angle, half of the nozzle angle. So, you take tan alpha. So, alpha equal to tan inverse of 2.5, opposite side by adjacent side. So, 2.5 divided by 8 equal to 1.79 degree. But the angle of the divergent portion. So, the angle of the divergent portion is 2 alpha. So, cone angle of the divergent portion equal to 2 alpha equal to 3.58 degree. That is the answer. So, we have to calculate the cone angle of the divergent portion, which is 3.58, and the velocity at the throat section and the condition at the throat section that we have already calculated. So, this is the end of the problem. Next problem from November 2018 question paper. A convergent nozzle for a steam turbine has to deliver steam under the supply condition of 11 bar and 100 degrees Celsius superheat and the back pressure and a back pressure of 0.15 bar. If the outlet area of the nozzle is 9.7 cm square, determine using steam table the mass of the steam discharged per hour. If the turbine converts 60% of total enthalpy drop into useful work, determine the power developed by the turbine. Neglect the effect of friction in the nozzle. Take Cp of the steam equal to 2.3 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, the given data, so P1, it is a convergent nozzle, so P1 equal to 11 bar. And the degree of superheat, so what is given 100 degrees Celsius is the superheat temperature. So, T1 minus TS1 equal to 100 degrees Celsius. So, TS1 is the saturation temperature, T1 is the temperature of the superheated steam at the inlet. So, P2 equal to 0.15 bar, area is given as 9.7 cm square and the turbine converts 0.6 times of enthalpy drop. So, the enthalpy drop H1 minus H2 we have to calculate. So, WT equal to 0.6 times of enthalpy drop, and the Cp value is 2.3 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, from steam table at 11 bar, so we have to note down the properties. TS1 184.1 degree Celsius, HG1 2779.7 kilojoules per kilogram, SG1 6.55 kilojoules per kilogram, 11 bar pressure. So, the extract of the table is given here, you note it down. Then, properties of the steam at the inlet. So, we are given T1 minus TS1 equal to 100. So, T1 equal to 100 plus TS1 equal to 100 plus 184.1 equal to 284.1 degree Celsius, which is 557.1 Kelvin. Now, H1 equal to HG1 for superheated steam. H1 equal to HG1 plus Cp into T1 minus TS1 equal to 2779.7 plus 2.3 into 100. So, 2.3 is also given. Specific heat of the steam is also given, 2.3 into 100 equal to 3009.7 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific entropy for superheated steam, S1 equal to SG1 plus Cp into logarithmic of T1 by TS1 equal to 6.55 plus 2.3 into logarithmic of 557.1 divided by 184.1 plus 273. So, calculating S1 equal to 7.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now, from the steam table at 0.1 bar pressure, so you take, refer the table, page number 12. So, I have shown extraction of the steam table here, 0.1 bar pressure. We have note down the properties. For isentropic flow, S1 equal to S2. So, S1 equal to, we assume at the outlet it is wet steam, SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, 7.005 equal to 0.755 plus X2 into 7.254, calculating X2 equal to 0.86. Now, the properties of the steam at the outlet, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. So, 226 plus 0.86 into 2373 equal to 2266.95 kilojoules per kilogram. And V2 equal to X2 into VG2. So, 0.78 into 10.023, which is 7.818 meter cube per kilogram. Now, velocity of the steam at the outlet, so V2 equal to 2 into H1 minus H2, which is 2 into 3009.7 minus 2266.95 into 1000 to convert kilojoules into joules. So, calculating the velocity of the outlet is 1218.8 meters per second. So, the mass flow rate of the steam, mass of the steam discharged, M equal to A2 V2 by small v2. So, A2 is the area. It is given 9.7 10 power minus 4. So, we are given 9.7 centimeter square. So, 9.7 10 power minus 4 into velocity equal to 1218.8. So, divided by the specific column 7.818. So, calculating the mass flow rate is 0.151 kilograms per second, which is 543.6 kilograms per hour. So, multiplying by 3600. So, 543.6 kilograms per hour. And the power delivered by the turbine, M equal to, P equal to M into H1 minus H2 into 0.6. So, 60% of the enthalpy drop. So, M equal to 0.151 into 3009.7 minus 2266.95 into 0.6 equal to 67.29 kilowatt. That is the power delivered by the turbine. And the example number 7 from the University question paper, May 2009, dry saturated steam at a pressure of 8 bar enters a convergent divergent nozzle and leaves it at a pressure of 1.5 bar. If the flow is isentropic and the corresponding expansion index is 1.135, find the ratio of cross sectional area at the exit and the throat for the maximum discharge. And this is the convergent divergent nozzle. The steam enters here with a dry condition. So, P1 equal to 8 bar and dry saturated steam, and P3 at the exit pressure is 1.5 bar, and the index of expansion for dry steam, so n equal to 1.135. Now, the extract of the steam table for the given condition, 8 bar and dry saturated steam, so it is given here, 8 bar, we have to take the properties, dry saturated steam, H1 equal to HG1 equal to 2767. 0.4 kilojoules per kilogram, S1 equal to SG1 equal to 6.66 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now the critical pressure ratio, pressure at the throat section, we calculate P2 by P1 equal to 2 by n plus 1 by n plus 1 to the power n by n minus 1. Now here n equal to 1.135 for dry saturated steam. So P2 equal to 8 into 2 by 1.135 plus 1 to the power 1.135 divided by 1.135 minus 1. Calculating pressure at the throat section, P2 equal to 4.6 bar. Now from the steam table at the 4.6 bar, you note down the properties. So you take the 4.6 bar, so you note down all the properties. For isentropic flow, S1 equal to S2. So at the entry of the nozzle, the steam is dry saturated steam. So beyond that, so at the throat section, at the exit section, the steam will be in the wet condition. So at the throat, we assume that it is wet condition, wet steam. So S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So S1 equal to 6.66, SF2 equal to 1.829 plus X2 into 5.018. So calculating X2 equal to 0.96. Now we calculate the properties of the steam at the throat section. H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. So 626.7 plus 0.96 into 2117.2, which is 2659.2 kilojoules per kilogram. And the V2 specific volume equal to X2 into VG2. So 0.96 into 0.40526, which is 0.389 meter cube per kilogram. Now the velocity at the throat section, V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2. So square root of 2 into 2767.4 minus 2659.2 into 1000 equal to 465.2 meters per second. Now from steam table at outlet pressure P3 equal to 1.5 bar. So we take the, I have shown the extract of the steam table. So we have to note down the properties at 1.5 bar. So all the properties you read the values. Now for isentropic flow in the nozzle, S1 equal to S3. So S1 equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3. So 6.66 equal to 1.433 plus X3 into 5.79. So calculating X3 equal to 0.9. Now the properties of steam at the outlet. So H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3, which is 467.1 plus 0.9 into 226.3 equal to 2470.77 kilojoules per kilogram. V3 equal to X3 into VG3, which is 0.9 into 1.159 equal to 1.043 meter cube per kilogram. So the velocity at the exit section, so you can take 2 into H1 minus H7, H1 minus H3, which is 2 into square root of 2 into 2767.4 minus 2470.77 into 1000 equal to 770.2 meters per second. Now, we have to calculate the ratio of cross-sectional area at the exit and the throat for maximum discharge. So, A3 by A2 equal to, from the continuity equation, combining the continuity equation, A3 by A2 equal to capital V2 by small V2 into small V3 by capital V3. So 465.2 divided by 0.389 into 1.043 divided by 770.2, the area ratio equal to 1.619. That is the answer to the question. And example number 8, in a steam nozzle, steam expands from 12 bar and 300 degrees Celsius to 6 bar with a flow rate of 5 kilograms per second. Determine the exit area if exit velocity is 500 meters per second and the velocity at the inlet is negligible. Also find the coefficient of velocity. So this is from May 2009 question paper. So the given data, inlet pressure P1 equal to 12 bar, inlet temperature T1 equal to 300 degrees Celsius, pressure at the exit P2 equal to 6 bar, mass flow rate is 5 kilograms per second. Actual velocity at the outlet is 500 meters per second. So we designate V2A. And V1 equal to 0, inlet velocity is equal to 0. So for superheated steam, P1 equal to 12 bar and 300 degrees Celsius. So we take the properties of the superheated steam. So 12 bar, 300 degrees Celsius. So 3046.9. And the specific entropy, 12 bar, 300 degrees Celsius, 7.034 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So this is page number 19 and 22. Enthalpy of superheated steam and the specific entropy of the superheated steam. So So from steam table at P2, exit pressure P2 equal to 6 bar, HG2 equal to 2755.5 kilojoules per kilogram, SG2 equal to 6.758 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, VG2 equal to 0.31546 meter cube per kilogram, and the saturation temperature TS2 equal to 158.8 degrees Celsius, which is 431.8 Kelvin. Now, from the steam table at exit pressure P2 equal to 6 bar, we find that S1 is greater than SG2. So, 7.034 is greater than 6.758. So, the steam is superheated at the exit. So, for superheated steam, S1 equal to S2. So, we assume S2 equal to superheated. So, S1 equal to SG2 plus Cp into logarithmic of T2 by TS2. Substituting 7.034 equal to 6.758 plus 2.2 into logarithmic of T2 by 431.8. So, calculating logarithmic of T2 by 431.8 equal to 7.034 minus 6.758 divided by 2.2 equal to 0.138. So, you take the exponential T2 by 431.8 equal to exponential of 0.138, e to the power 0.138 equal to 1.15. So, the temperature of the steam at the outlet is 496.57 Kelvin, or it is 23.57 degree Celsius. Now, we calculate the enthalpy. Enthalpy H2 equal to HG2 plus Cp into T2 minus TS2, which is 2755.5 plus 2.2 into 223.57 minus 158.8 equal to 2898 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific volume of the superheated steam at the outlet, V2 equal to VG2 into T2 by TS2 equal to 0.31546 into 496.57 divided by 431.8 equal to 0.363 meter cube per kilogram. And the area of nozzle, area at exit of the nozzle, A2 equal to M into V2 divided by capital V2 velocity. So, 5 into 0.363 divided by 500 equal to 3.63 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. And velocity of the exit for isentropic flow. So, for isentropic flow, we have V2S equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2. So, square root of 2 into 3046.9 minus 2898 into 1000 for converting kilojoules into joules. The velocity is 545.7 meters per second. So, the coefficient of velocity is ratio of actual velocity divided by the isentropic velocity. So, V2A divided by V2S equal to 500 divided by 545.7 equal to 0.916. That is the answer to the problem. So, we stop here. So, thank you for watching. You please post your comments on the YouTube video text box. So, if you have any queries, you can contact me. You subscribe the YouTube channel so that you will get the updated video. You can write to my mail ID for any clarification or doubt. So, thank you for watching once again. We'll meet again in the next video with additional problems.